Maliha Kadir is founding managing director of Shohoz and joins us now live here at the STX. Welcome. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
How's business?
Business is doing well. We are growing tremendously. We're doing around more than a million rides now, on 1.2 million rides only in Dhaka in motorbike. And we have grown tremendously over the last 9 months that we have been in, we have been doing ride sharing. So things are going well. And we just closed a big funding round, $15 million, which is the largest in tech in Bangladesh to date.
And you've got some big, you know, investors coming through too. You've got some big support, big JVs.
Absolutely. And we are very excited. We are very excited to be having Golden Gate as our investor. 500 startups, Golden Gate, Linear Venture, Singaporean angel, Mr. Koh Boon Wee, they all invested in this round. And it's been fantastic. It's not just money. They come with a lot of experience and know-how and knowledge, and we are getting the benefit of that as well.
Okay, what's your biggest threat right now?
Biggest threat is obviously there's always a threat of competition in the market. We have two other players. Uber's been there, and there's a local player as well. So, you know, it's figuring out, I mean, it's working through our differentiation, building up the business, and, you know, doing, executing on it. So that is, you know, in ride hailing everywhere, there are a few players in all markets, we have seen that. So that competition will be coming, and, you know, we are prepared for it. We have raised the money, we have the good team with us, and we are working through it.
Maliha, what makes Shohoz different then? What makes you guys stand out from the competition, which I'm sure is fierce?
Absolutely, absolutely. So it's not as fierce as it has been in Southeast Asia and other markets yet, because ride-hailing itself is a very new concept in Bangladesh. So we started 1 year after the concept came about in Bangladesh, and 1 year is too small a time to call it shots, anybody a winner in such a young market. Bangladesh itself is growing. So in terms of differentiation, it's really everything. It's the quality of product, it's the quality of service, it's the price for value we are offering to our customers. So in every area, I would say that we are differentiating ourselves vis-a-vis our competition. Localization is an important thing for markets like Bangladesh, which is where we are working actively against foreign players who don't localize for the market. So that's another differentiation. So I would say it's the entire execution of it, entire customer experience we are offering, the localization we are doing, plus the other services we are bringing on board on the platform.
Maliha, difficult question, I know, but what guarantee can you give to your customers, to your passengers, especially your female customers, that they will be safe when they travel with you?
So, look, nobody can guarantee safety in any travel platform. I mean, we've been working in bus industry previously. Nobody can guarantee. What we do is there's a lot of safety cautionary measures that we take. So there is the SOS button. You could call immediately to the government's 999 number for safety. There is verification of drivers that we do before we onboard them.
Drivers?
Yes, we have female drivers. And that's another exciting area we're looking into. Which is, it's very exciting to see women as well driving motorbikes. Driving isn't very common for women in Bangladesh, but we have seen that ride-hailing helps you make money, and it is safe, relatively safe, because somebody, the ride-hailing company, is recording the travel distance, the location, all of that. So generally, people in ride-hailing, interestingly, you would see in Bangladesh that people feel safer in ride-hailing apps as opposed to being on other public transport, because in ride-hailing, the driver's identity has been verified by the company. Plus, the driver has been vetted in various ways by the company. Plus, there is a way of calling the police in case of emergency, and all the rides are being recorded at the distance.
And I'm sure that's very reassuring. And Maliha, one thing that really fascinates me about what you guys do is that you seem to have found a ride-sharing business model that works in an emerging market, in a frontier market like Bangladesh. Is this a plug-and-play model that you can transplant into, say, a country like Sri Lanka? And northern Sri Lanka, post-conflict, is an area that I'm very familiar with. There's a prevalence of two-wheelers. There's a prevalence of tuk-tuks. Is it something that you can plug in and it will work in that context?
So I think localization is needed for every market in ride hailing. Not a whole lot of localization, so the models are scalable. But I would say that 80% of what we are doing could be probably taken to other countries, but there is that 20% that makes a difference. We have to study the local market and see what works there.
Okay. Maliha, so good to have you with us.